गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर हरिभाव वाघेरे, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी, महाराजा जीवाजीराव शिंदे महाविद्यालय श्रीगोंदा, डिस्ट्रिक्ट अहमदनगर। द मेन एम ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज ओनली फॉर एजुकेशनल पर्पज। आवर कॉलेज इज एफिलिएटेड टू सावित्रीबाई फुले यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ पुणे, एंड इन दिस यूनिवर्सिटी द सिलेबस इज अ क्रेडिट बेस्ड credit choice based credit system is there. In that choice based credit system, there are 2 credits in each paper. In each semester there are 35 marks for theory and 15 marks for the internal. In this way we have last time FIBSC paper number 2, that is plant morphology and anatomy. In that paper we have completed first credit. Then we have started second credit also. In that second credit the anatomy topic we have learned, and in anatomy last time we have completed the complex tissues, and in today's video we are going to learn about epidermal tissues. Then what is meaning by epidermal tissues? What is epidermal tissue? And the name indicates, epi means above and derma means skin. Epi means above, and we know that derma means skin. It is the outermost skin, or that is also known as the epidermis. And all plant organs beginning from the underground roots, the stem, leaves, fruits and seeds also, that all organs they have epidermis, and this layer represents the point of contact between the plants and the outer environment. The plant and the outer environment, and the connection between or the contact between these two factors, organ, plant organ and the environment, the connection between that is in epidermis, and therefore it exhibits diversities in structure. They have diversities in structure, and it is primarily protective tissue. What is the function of this epidermis? It is very important tissue which is a protective in function. It protects all the inner part of that organ or the plant, and that tissue, epidermal tissue, mainly include epidermal cells, stomata, trichomes, glandular hairs and motor cells. There are motor cells are also there, glandular hairs are also there, trichome is there, काटे म्हणतो आपण मराठी मध्ये, दॅट इज ट्रायकोम्स. देन व्हिच इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एपिडर्मल टिश्यूज, हाउ इट लुक्स लाइक, व्हिच इज द डिफरंट कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर्स ऑफ दॅट एपिडर्मल टिश्यू. एपिडर्मल सेल्स आर इसेन्शियली ट्यूबुलर. इट लुक्स लाइक अ ट्यूबुलर ट्यूब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. देअर डेप्थ रिलेटिवली लेस, जी खोली आहे ती कमी असते, अँड इन सरफेस व्ह्यू दे आर आयसोडायमॅट्रिक, ऑर इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज इलॉन्गेटेड. इट इज इलॉन्गेटेड स्ट्रक्चर, इट इज अ ट्युब्युलर स्ट्रक्चर, इट इज अ आयसोडायमॅट्रिक, दॅट इज द कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक्स फीचर ऑफ एपिडर्मल टिश्यूज. आयसोडायमॅट्रिक, ट्युब्युलर, इलॉन्गेटेड, अँड द अनदर कॅरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर इज दॅट एपिडर्मिस इज अ सिंगल लेयर्ड. In most of the plants it is single layer, but in some cases it may be multi-seriate, or it may be bi-seriate mano apan tela. When we take the example of banyan tree, apan marathi madhe tela word mhanto aahe, and the scientific name of that banyan tree is Ficus bengalensis. And nerium plant, another example, kaner mhanto marathi madhe apan tela. Different species of Neria. It is of two or multi-layered epidermis is there, means thick epidermis is there. In case of Neria, in case of Banyan, that is Ficus bengalensis. And the another characteristic features of epidermal tissue is that the cells are living. The cells are living. That is the one of the important characteristic features of epidermal tissue. Then the peripheral layer of protoplasm, it enclosing a large central vacuole. Large central vacuole is also there. And the sap in the vacuole may sometimes contain colored pigments, anthocyanin. We know that there is a colored pigment, and they give different colors to the fruit, to the flower, and to the leaves also. We know that in case of leaves, there are different pigments. If leaf is a yellow, then xanthan pigments is there. If leaf is a green, the chlorophyll pigment may be there. In this way, that pigments, they have colored or they have anthocyanin, that is called a colored pigments, that are present in the vacuole or the sap in the vacuoles, and they give different colors to different organs, and they are also occasionally present in stems also and petioles. They are also present in petioles, they are also present in the stem. Then, which is another characteristic features of the another type, that is stomata, which is the characteristic features of that stomata. These small stomata are small openings that are present on the upper and lower surface of the leaves, in some cases the stem also. And these are minute apertures bounded by two guard cells. दोन गार्ड सेल्स असतात त्याला, टू गार्ड सेल्स, संरक्षक पेशी म्हणून आपण थोडक्यात. किडनी शेप्ड स्ट्रक्चर इज द गार्ड सेल्स. दे आर फाउंड मेनली इन द इपिडर्मिस ऑफ लीव्स. वेर इट प्रेझेंट? इट इज प्रेझेंट इन द इपिडर्मिस ऑफ द लीव्स अँड यंगर पार्ट ऑफ द स्टेम ऑल्सो. स्टेमच्या यंगर पार्टमध्ये सुद्धा आपल्याला हा स्टोमाटा पाहायला मिळेल. अँड दे आर ऑब्सेंट इन द रूट्स. It is not present in the root. Root is the underground part of the plant, and the stomata are absent on the epidermis of the root. And which is another characteristic feature of the stomata? Each stoma may be interpreted as a intercellular space between two highly specialized epidermal cells. That cell is called a guard cell. Highly specialized structure is there, that is called the guard cells. And the guard cells are specialized epidermal cells with dense cytoplasm, chloroplasts, starch grains, and unevenly thickened walls also. In some plant groups, especially dicotyledonous plant group, we know that in angiosperms there are two groups, angiosperms, that is dicot and monocot. When we studied about the dicot plant or the dicot leaves, the stomata remain scattered in dicot leaves, while in monocot, which is the example of dicot, you take the example of sunflower, you take the hibiscus example, there are a lot of examples of the dicot plants. And when we take the peel off that leaves of the dicotyledonous plant, at that time we should found that stomata are scattered in that leaves. And in case of monocot, which is the different examples of monocot, when we jhiames maka amanto apan dela marathi madhe grasses, different families, different members of the grasses, Gramineae family, and they have a parallel rows of the stomata. Stomata are parallel they do not intersect each other, but in case of dicot they are scattered. Then, which is another characteristic feature of the stomata? Stomata are more abundant on the lower surface of the epidermis of the dorsiventral leaf. What is dorsiventral leaf? There are two surfaces, dorsal surface and ventral surface, that is called a dorsiventral surface, but there are some leaves we cannot identify which is the which side is upper and which side is lower, and when that type of leaf is a different, but dorsiventral leaf we can identify that this is a upper side, this is a lower side, that leaf is called a dorsiventral leaf, and they are absent or very few on upper surface. Stomata are very few in number on the upper surface, whereas on the lower surface there are large number of stomata are present in the plant. Then when we take the example of sunflower, when we take the example of sunflower leaf, number of stomata on lower surface is more than that of upper surface. Upper surface piksha jast khali lower surface la stomata the number jast hai. Upon example, we can take the leaves of sunflower, take the peel, or with the help of blade we can take that peel off that leaf on the slide, and we can understood the stomata also. Then in isobilateral leaves, stomata are more or less evenly distributed on both surfaces. Then which is the functions of the epidermal cells, epidermal tissues? The main function of the stomata is to what is the main functions of that epidermal tissues? What is the main function? The main function of the stomata is to allow the exchange of gases, with help of this stomata there is a exchange of gases, then oxygen for respiration and carbon dioxide for photosynthesis is exchanged through that stomata. In this way, this is the one of the important function of the stomata. Then stomata also help in the plant in getting rid of excess of water in the form of a water vapor, and that process is called a transpiration. When there is a loss of water through the aerial part of the plant, through the stomata, through the lenticels, that is called a transpiration, and this is the main function of these stomata, loss of water in the form of a vapor, and this loss of water is called as a transpiration. I have told that definition, there is a loss of water. Then another example, in this video we have studied some of the important two important part of the epidermal tissues, that is a structure of epidermal tissue. It is a tubular epidermis is a single layered, cells are living, and sap in a vacuole contain colored pigments. That colored pigments plays very vital role in the formation of the fruit and stem also, and then leaves also. In this way, in epidermal tissue we have learned about the meaning of that, that is epi means above, derma means skins. Then structure of the stomata, which is the how that stomata are there in plant. There is a minute aperture, or that is also known as a small opening, which is present on the upper and lower surface of the leaf. They found in the epidermis, the stomata that are always found in the epidermal region. Then guard cells are specialized cells that are present in the epidermis. Then in dicot leaves, stomata are scattered, and opposite to that in monocot, the stomata that are in parallel. Okay. Then the abundant or lower epidermis, that is one of the important characteristic features of the stomata. The stomata are abundant or more in lower surface as compared to upper surface. Okay. Then and few, very few on the upper surface, and which is the function of the stomata. In this way we have studied that there are different functions. The main function of stomata is to allow exchange of gases, oxygen for respiration and carbon dioxide for photosynthesis, that are exchanged with the help of this pore, with the help of this aperture. And it is also getting rid of excess water, if there is excess water absorbed by the roots, and that water also evaporated in the form of a vapor by this stomata, and that process is called a transpiration. In this way, in this small video, we have learnt all that things. Thank you for watching.